Hi and welcome back to another Amazon selling video. My name is Nikki Kirk and I've been selling on Amazon doing retail arbitrage for 4 years now, or just about. We're coming up to 4 years. And I am finally back in my RV office. If you've been hanging out for a little while, I have been out renovating my RV, so I've not been living in it, but last night we moved back in and as you just probably saw, my cats are back in and ready to run. So it's not totally done because I'm not sure if you can see, but the stairs there are not finished. So we're gonna finish up a few things and then hopefully hit the road soon. Here's a photo of the office so far. I am really excited about my desk because one, I built it myself, really. I mean, it's just a butcher block that I stained and then I got the legs off of Amazon and you just drill them in and voila, I love this desk. I'm super excited. All right, enough about that. So in this video, really quickly, I just want to break down meltable inventory. And you probably got an email from Amazon that just says, you know, from April 15th to October 15th, you can't sell anything that's meltable. So what is meltables and why do they have this going on? Every year this email goes out and it's a yearly thing. So in the summer, obviously the shipping trucks and warehouses get too hot. And so Amazon can't deliver a product that's meltable to a customer and like assure that it's gonna get there not melted, right? This email is only talking about FBA inventory because it's just talking about the warehouses. You could still FBA meltables if you want to, and a little bit later on I'll break down why you might want to, but just know that this video is only talking about FBA inventory. When you think about meltables, you probably automatically think things like chocolate or candles, you know, things that melt. But it's also talking about items like gummies or vitamins. It's any items that Amazon deems heat sensitive, and that just means that it can't withstand temperatures like stored temperatures of 75 to 155 degrees. Amazon has a whole spreadsheet of the SKUs for 2021, which I will link below, or you can just search in Seller Central for meltable inventory and it breaks it down right there. There's a link there that says the ASINs. The good news is that there's actually not that many products that fall into this meltable heat sensitive category. And there's even better news if you're doing FBM, because the items that do fall into that category go up in price on Amazon. So if you are willing to sell and send these meltable items, which obviously you don't want to send like chocolate in Florida, you know, there's considerations, but things like gummies that maybe won't melt, you can actually send them FBM, and I'm telling you that I've actually done this. So you have to use it at your own discretion, but I've shipped gummy vitamins, I've shipped chocolates. So it's really up to you and what you think is best, because you really don't want your customer to get something melted, so you have to use your judgment on that. But if you can do it, or there's things that fall into the category that maybe shouldn't necessarily be, or that won't really melt, those kind of items you can make a lot of profit doing FBM during the summer. So definitely something to consider. There's actually some protein bars that year round don't make a lot of profit, but then in the summer months when you can't FBA them anymore, they start making a lot of profit. So that's what I look forward to every summer, because they're not really meltable. They'll be totally fine being shipped, but Amazon deems them meltable. They can't sit in the warehouse. So I win. Okay, now for the bad news. It doesn't tell you this when you're scanning. It very rarely will tell you that the item is considered a meltable. So when you're out scanning, you think you found something and you get it home and you find out you can't send it in because it's meltable. Sometimes you eat the product, sometimes you gotta take it back to the store. It's really up to you. There's a few ways that you can determine in store if you think it might be a meltable if Amazon seller app is not telling you it is. One is if it has chocolate in the name, that's pretty much a given. And I mean that because one time I was scanning a chocolate, I think it was like a brownie mix or something. It was like a dry cake brownie mix of some sort. It was chocolate flavored, but there was nothing in it that was gonna melt. So I grabbed it, didn't think anything of it, and then I got it home and it said it couldn't send in because it was meltable. And I was like, what? It was because it had chocolate in the name. Another thing, which is honestly the best way to go, is if you don't see any FBA sellers on it, the price is pretty high and it's a lot of FBM sellers. That is pretty much a given that you can assume that that is a meltable product, and that's why you're not seeing any FBA sellers on it. So those are just two ways to kind of help you. But like I said, you might just have to return stuff to the store, or hey, if it's gonna make a profit, just go ahead and list it FBM. Now there may be items that are very clearly meltable, but for whatever reason, Amazon will allow you to send them in FBA. I don't recommend this. If you're sure that it's not gonna last, you don't want a customer to get a melted product at the end of the day, because it's gonna look bad at you and the seller, and we are all trying to run professional businesses here. You don't wanna skim, you don't wanna take any cut corners, because it's only gonna hurt your Amazon account in the end. So just because it lets you send it, you need to really consider, should you send it? Depending how quickly your warehouse is checking stuff in and how fast your item is gonna sell, obviously the lower rank is gonna sell faster, I would still keep sending stuff in until around March 24th, which, hey, happens to be my birthday, because that will allow you enough time to get it to the warehouse, it to be checked in, and you still have like 2 weeks of sales. And most of my stuff, I try to have sold within 2 weeks. And if it's that kind of product, it should be selling fast. So just things to consider, but don't freak out and stop sending it right now, because you still have another couple of weeks to go and you can send it in. If you want to know if any of your inventory is on the meltable list, Amazon has the whole Excel list of what they're considering meltables for 2021. I went ahead and pulled a couple items up just to show you some examples. So if you were just to search on Google or in your Seller Central meltable FBA inventory, you'll see this page, which breaks it all down for you. It is probably literally word for word what was in the email that we were sent. But here is a list of meltable ASINs if you want to go ahead and check on it. I will link this page to the video description below just so you can find it easier, but it's there for you. So I pulled up some so you can take a look at what they actually are. So here's one example of these Whole Foods bars that were on the list. Because they are chocolate chip, they are going to melt. Another one is obviously Cadbury chocolates. One, these sound delicious. I don't even know what these are, but they sound good. But two, they are meltable. And then another example is these vitamins. So any kind of gummy vitamin, and you, these are the ones you might not necessarily think are meltable, but they are, because they'll kind of like smoosh to the bottom of the thing if they are stored at too high of a heat. Now when October rolls around and it's Halloween candy time, unfortunately in 2020 they pushed the date to October 15th, but it used to be September 30th. But anyways, now it's October 15th, so it's too late for Halloween candy. But here's a tip for you for when October does roll around. If you start scanning the Halloween candy when it starts to get on the shelf, you will notice that there's a lot of high profit, especially in bundles. And the reason is that it's still not be able to send FBA, so FBM commands usually a little bit of a higher price for those kind of items, and you'll see some really great profits. And normally in October, on most of the states, it's totally fine to ship stuff because the temperatures are not as hot anymore, but we'll see. But just know that, because I was scanning, I think it was in early or late September, some Halloween candy, and it was really high profit. So just something to consider and tip for the future. Now they do tell you that you can remove your product, or they'll remove it for you if you need to. And if you've never done a removal order before, I'm just going to show you how to do it. It's super simple. It costs 50 cents an item to have stuff shipped back to you. Sometimes when things like this happen, they might do a free removals starting like April 1st, so we'll see if that happens or not, where you can ask for anything back. It's not just meltable, just anything back, and you will get it back for free. There's no cost to you. So let me just really quickly walk you through how to do a removal order if you want it. From your manage inventory screen, you're just gonna click on the product you want to have removed, or products if there's multiple. Then you will go here to create removal order. You'll click that. And if you've never done one before, it will not have your address, but if you have done one before, or it just has your address there, you can go ahead and save your address now, which is nice, but you just say which ones you want back and they will ship back. It does take a couple of weeks sometimes to get the product back, so just know that. And that's really it. That's the meltable inventory. If you guys have any questions or want to see a future video for me, please let me know. I'd be happy to make them and help you out. If you need help engaging as a US seller or Canada seller, I have my ungating guides. As always, they are linked below. They are affordable and new seller specific, so you can get ungated and start shopping in the high profit categories like grocery, topical, health and personal care, beauty, toys, all of that. And as always, thank you guys so much for watching, and happy sourcing.